Well, they said we're coming to the United States, whatever that meant. I thought we were just going up the road to some mystical place. When I finally saw a map in kindergarten of how far we had traveled, I remember being not only astonished, but literally terrified. My father was a standard kind of crazy Latino military guy who would check his children's hands and their shoes and their clothes and their hair before we left the house. I mean, we had to tie our shoes a certain way. I lived in what I call the little dictatorship, the little dictatorship of our house. When I immigrated to New Jersey, it was a very crazy time. I immigrated in 1974, a few months before the fall of Saigon. This was not a place that was very welcoming. I found myself facing a tremendous amount of racism and bigotry, but not just from like white Americans, from black Americans and from Latinos. I think if every immigrant child in this country was allowed to tell the real emotional truth of their experience here, people in the United States would discover that we actually make immigration a more horrific experience than it needs to be. And I feel that as a country, we're in a dream where there are no mistakes, there is no evil, we are always good, we hurt no one. You know, you can't grow if you admit no mistakes.